If this tutorial helped you, please use hashtag ATNfeedback on your picture and I will swing a like and a comment. What's up guys, this is ATN Designs here and I'll be teaching you how to make this design right here. And I'll be doing this design with Kevin Garnett instead of LeBron James so I could show you the process. And by the way, if you do not follow me yet, go follow me at ATN Designs. I have lots of different designs and edits on there. I'll be posting more on this YouTube channel. Just request what you guys would like, either in my Instagram comments or on the YouTube comments, whatever you guys feel the need to do. That didn't even make sense, but I don't care. All right, so just open up a new file, and you gotta do a 650 by 650 and do 100 resolution. That is perfect for Instagram size. So what we're going to start off with, we're going to put the grunge wallpaper, which is what you are going to need. And I'll have that and everything else you need in the description below. So just size that so it fits. Pretty good. Hold up. Some parts of this tutorial, I'm going to just like skip through so you don't have to watch like the boring parts. But I'll make sure you guys know what you're doing. And if you guys have any questions, just comment below and I'll answer them. Alright, so we got to start off with this little wallpaper like that. Just do it like that. And what you want to do first is you want to get this text to look like this. So what you're going to do, you have to come up with a nickname that'll fit and look nice. And make sure you're using the text called Impact right here at the top left corner. And what I'm going to do for KG, I'm giving him his nickname, Big Ticket. And as you know, KG was on the Timberwolves, the Celtics, and then the Nets. So for each team, you gotta do like the color that you want. So what you're gonna do is you put like right here, like right close to the bottom, close to the middle. So let's say, all right, we'll do three colors for each. So the Timberwolves, I'll give them like a lightish blue. Maybe a little bit more, something like that, like this, wait. Actually, something like a darker blue. It'll look better. Alright, so we got a dark blue for the Timberwolves. For Celtics, obviously, we're going to do green. And for the Nets, we'll do black. Or maybe, no, we'll do gray. Alright. It's not going to look so good right now, but once you get the pictures and all that, it'll look cool. Trust me. Alright, I'll do maybe a darker gray, so it stands out more. Alright, like that. What you want to do next is you want to find a bunch of pictures that you would want. You have to get a picture for each letter inside of here. So we're going to start off with three pictures from when he was on the Timberwolves. So F and Timberwolves. And you just get whatever picture. And you got to pay attention to this part really quick because some people will get confused. It's really not hard at all. So just make it fit so that it'll look good inside of the letter. All you gotta do is you have to grab this tool right here, the magic wand, and you go to this layer, the text layer first, and you click like around the outline of it, and then what you do is you go back to layer number two, which is the Kevin Garnett picture, right, and you just delete it so that it fits right inside of the letter. And then what you gotta do is you lower the opacity to 50, like right around 50. Okay, like that. All right, let me fix this real quick because when there's like a little hole in between the letter, it doesn't delete it right away. So just zoom in, make sure you get that out, or else it's gonna look weird. Okay, like that. Make sure you get the edges. All right, so you got to do like that. All right, like that, right? And then what you do is you go to the image and then adjustments, use saturation, and then you go to colorize and you do like around the same exact color of what this color is. And then you got to make sure you remember what you use for like each one. So this one will be 230 for the U, and then however you say that, and then 25 for saturation and 0 for lightness. And now make sure I do that for each of those colors. Alright guys, so I am back and I just finished this text you got here. So we're already almost done with this. Well, not almost, but like halfway done. So now we need to just find three pictures, one of each. To go, one for the Timberwolves to go right here, one for the Celtics in the middle, and one for the Nets on the right. So here, we have a good one right here. I just got a text message. Okay, so what you gotta do is just scale it down. Really simple and easy right here. Alright. So make sure it's like a good size. Like that. Maybe a little bigger actually. Hold on, let me fix that. Alright, something like that. And what you gotta do is make it black and white. And you go to the erase tool. And what you do is you make the flow like around like 20 or like 18, something low. And all you gotta do is just erase it, basically. So that it gives it that grunge effect around him. Like that. Like that. And then what you do is you go back to the flow, go back to 100, and then just erase all the darkness in the background. You don't want that there. Alright, something like that. And if you want to make it stand out more, you can just duplicate the layer. Like that, and then just fix it up again. Something like that. Alright, so we got him down for the Nets. Okay, so now we shall go to the Celtics. Alright, so let's see. Oh, maybe we could just find PNG, it'd be easier. Just for a tutorial. Yeah, this one right here looks pretty good. Alright. Paste. Scale it down a little bit. Something like that. A little bit smaller. Like this, yeah. Wait, hold on 1 second, guys. I will be right back. I just gotta get a phone call real quick. Alright, so the next part of this is you just gotta do the same thing we just did for the Nets version of KG. So, what we're gonna do is we're gonna erase his legs right here so it doesn't get in the way. And you just go to flow, put it back up to around like 20-ish. Just dab all over, make him have that grunge effect. And then you put it on black and white. And there you go, you have that now. Hold on, let me just fix the... This one is looking kind of weird. The Nets one. See how the edges, it's like black, I don't want that. Try to fix that up. Okay. Alright, fix that one, fix the middle one, and all we need now is the Timberwolves. See, is this a cool picture actually? Yeah, why not? Alright, let's try this. Okay, so, do the same thing one more time. Alright, black and white, and erase around the edges now. Make it a little bit bigger, the eraser tool. Alright, so look at this. We're getting closer to this now. Alright, so what you want to do now is you could just add his actual name right above the nickname. And I use a font, it sounds funny, but it's called Big Noodle Titling. And that font is very good for like designs and stuff. You could put his name below or above. I usually do it above because you have to put the team logos underneath. They're a little bit smaller, like something like 24 font. That And then what you want to do is you want to go to Blur. Go to, like, it's called Gaussian Blur, which is rasterize the layer. And then you just blur it out a little bit, makes it look better. And if you want, you can lower the opacity a little. All right. So now, what we got to do is type in each team logo, find the PNG, Timberwolves. Look what I just typed there. Timberwolves, my bad. Put this, just put the actual logo, not the text logo. You paste it on there, make it smaller, and put it underneath the text. And what you're going to do is you're just going to use your eraser tool and put that little grunge effect on it. Okay, now Celtics. Their logo has a text in there, so that's why I just do that one. Scale. Make sure it's like the same size each time. So, and then just drag it over perfectly to the middle. Okay. Now grunge this one. Alright. And now you're at the Nets logo. Right, this one right here. Oops. Alright, copy image. Paste. Alright. And then what you're gonna do is just size it perfectly. And shift it over to the middle. Alright, now it's grunges too. And the last thing we have to do is fix the big ticket text. And we have to give it that little glow effect, as you see here we have on the King James. So what we're gonna do is look. See, so all you gotta do is just change the outer glow and just mess around with it a little bit. So I'm just gonna do the same thing I did there for this one. So go to outer glow, make it black, put it on normal. Put the opacity all the way up, size to like around like 8, and the spread to something around like 15, like that. And just drag it down maybe a little bit. Hold on. Oh wait, hold on, I just realized something. Yeah, you know what, just leave it how it is, because the pictures are inside it. But that's basically all you need to know how to do for this. And then I just add my watermark, paste it, and there you go. That's all you need to know, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial, and stay tuned for more.